Magandang buhay mga kabiyahe! Are you all excited? Let me introduce myself. I am Kersey Balita, but you can call me Kersey, your tour leader for this trip. Beside me is our coach captain.
I would like to introduce myself. I am Jake Chan, your coach captain. I will ensure our safe and fun travel. I am pleased to tell you the rest of my team, the co-tour guides.
I'm Maui.
And I'm Ella.
Just a reminder, we must follow the safety protocols to ensure the safety against COVID-19. Please keep a meter distance, wear your face mask and face shield at all times, and don't forget to sanitize each and after visit of a destination. Aside from the reminders regarding new normal protocols, please be guided about the other reminders for this tour. First is, if I raise my pink flag, and it means we are heading to the next place or attraction. And if I whistle twice, it means we are heading back to the shuttle. In my watch, it's 7 o'clock a.m. So can I request everyone to sync your time with me at 7 o'clock a.m. to avoid conflict in our schedule? Since we are now nearing at our first destination, are you all excited, my dear tourists?
Yes!
And now let's have a head count starting with you, my dear tourists. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. Alright guys, we are all set. Let's go to our first destination that is something new. First on the list will be Cebu. Cebu attracts millions of tourists every year for many reasons, but the major pull is its pristine beaches. Cebu is also famous for its diverse marine life and otherworldly coral reefs. Diverse flocks Pescador Island, Mualboal, for the Sardine Run and Turtle Point, followed by a trip to Oslo to swim with the sharks.
Did you have fun at Cebu? We are now going to our second destination. It is known as the surfing capital of the Philippines. Surigao is mainly responsible for introducing surfing to the country. Apart from surfing, Surigao is also open to other activities such as cave explorations and rock climbing. Surigao is arguably one of the best surfing hotspots in Asia, boasting waves all year round. Among its numerous surf breaks, Cloud 9 is the most legendary wave that attracts professional surfers from around the world. Now, let's proceed to our third destination. Take it away, tour guide Maui!
Almeida has been named a number of times by travel publication sites as the best island beaches in the world because of its paradise-like attractions with white sand, turquoise waters, vibrant coral reefs, and stunning limestone cliffs. Almeida, the gateway to the awe-inspiring Bakit Archipelago, which houses 45 islands and islets, each with its unique geological formations. It's no wonder that Almeida has been ranked consistently as one of the best island destinations, not just in the Philippines, but in the world. There are a lot of things to do in Almeida, from island hopping, lounging on beaches, hiking up cliffs, and even scuba diving. Reading this guide in Almeida, Palawan will make it easy for you to plan a trip and maximize your time in one of the best islands in the Philippines. For the last destination, we have tour guide Jake.
We are now going to the summer capital of the Philippines, Boracay. There is no shortage of pristine beaches in the Philippines. But if you're looking for a more active beach scene, one of the best places to visit is White Beach in Boracay. This is the most populous beach on the island, but where you will find ample opportunities for boating and other water sports.
Are you still awake, my dear tourists?
Yes!
Did you enjoy our prepared destinations?
Yes!
Now let's proceed to the most popular attractions here in the Philippines. First on the list is Las Casas Filipinas de Acozar. It is a heritage park in the province of Bataan. Las Casas Filipinas de Acozar was constructed amid European embrace of the champion emotion, individualism, and nature during the first half of 19th century. Comprised of 30 different heritage houses, each building represents an aspect of national Filipino history.
known as the Walled City. Intramuros is a place rich in history and culture. In between the walls of Intramuros is the mark that 300 years of Spanish rule had left in the form of grand churches and the colonial houses. Intramuros is famous for its culture, its food, and its atmosphere. Numerous monuments can be found like the Manila Cathedral, San Agustin Church, or the Palacio del Gobernador.
Our next destination is famous aside from being known for its healing. Camay ni Jesus is also famous for its 300-step climb to the huge statue of Jesus. Some say it's only about 200, but we counted and estimated the steps to be at 300. It is important to note that some of the steps are steep, so you really need a lot of energy to reach the top.
Who among you loves cameras? Vintage? Or even antique? Well, you will truly enjoy our next attraction because we are now here in Galleria Taal. You will be delighted to see the well-cared vintage camera that has been preserved for everyone to see. But then, not just those who love camera will enjoy and appreciate this place, because I am pretty sure that everyone will be amazed by the story of this museum. Galleria Taal is formerly known as the Elagan Barrian House. This house used to be the ancestral home of Don Domingo Elagan and Dona Maria Martinez. Mr. Manny Enumerable, a camera collector, was the one who converted the house into what is now the Galleria Taal, a camera museum. Galleria Taal was reconstructed in 2004. It was opened in 2010, exhibiting the owner's collection of antique and rare cameras from the late 1800s up to 1900s. In this museum, there are also a vast of antiquarian Philippine photographs from the Spanish and American era, and also the Marcos years and the Edsa Revolution.
And that is the end of our tour. We have a great time guiding you here in the Philippines, and we hope that you learned a lot and enjoyed from this travel. On behalf of Biyahe Travel and Tours, we wish you a relaxing and enjoyable stay here in the Philippines. Have a safe travel and hope to service to you again.